The scale is used to express distance on a map. Some maps use a linear scale, also known as a scale bar, such as the one shown here. Some maps use a word statement to express scale. For example, 1 centimeter equals 1 kilometer. Other maps use a representative fraction. Topographic maps produced by the United States Geological Survey use 1 to 24,000. This means that 1 inch on the map equals 24,000 inches in the real world. Another common representative fraction used is 1 to 63,360, that is, 1 inch to 1 mile. Other countries scale their maps in metrics. Representative fractions such as 1 to 50,000, 1 to 250,000, and 1 to 1 million are commonly used. For example, on a map with a scale of 1 to 50,000, 1 centimeter equals 50,000 centimeters in reality. Maps are often known as large scale or small scale. Large scale maps are called large scale because features will appear bigger on the map. Street maps, for example, are large scale maps. On small scale maps, features will appear smaller. Maps of the world are considered small scale maps.
We can also use the scale of a map to measure distance. I have a topographic map here of the Ruapehu ski fields with a scale of 1 to 12,500. There's also a scale bar on this map. Now, I recently climbed to the dome shelter here on Mount Ruapehu from the top of the T-bar here, which comes from the Noel Ridge Cafe. Now, I want to measure how far it is from this T-bar to the dome. However, the route I took actually was not straight because I went up this valley here and then I came up onto this ridge called Restful Ridge, and eventually I walked along the top of a ridge here until I got to the dome shelter. So what I got here is I got a piece of wiry string, and I'm going to bend the string so that we start here from the top of the T-bar. We'll bend it till we get up to the ridge, and you got where I've turned, and right here is the dome shelter. I'm holding in my left hand the bent piece of string. Where my left hand is actually pincing, that is where the dome shelter was. And this end of the string is where the end of the T-bar was. And now I've got this 30 centimeter ruler, and I'm going to straighten the string alongside the ruler. I'm going to see how long this string actually is. Now, after straightening the string out and measuring it against the ruler, it comes to 16 centimeters. Now, what happens after this depends on the type of scale I'll use to do the calculation. Now, if we're going to use the scale bar, we've got to measure it with our ruler. Now, you can see here on the scale bar that 0 to 1,000 meters is the same as 8 centimeters on the ruler. Now, I measured out 16 centimeters for the journey that I climbed, and 16 centimeters works out to be 2 kilometers on the scale bar. If I'm going to use the representative fraction of 1 to 12,500, I will simply multiply the distance I ruled on the ruler by this denominator. So I will go 16 centimeters multiplied by 12,500, and this, you can see, comes to 200,000 centimeters. And when you convert 200,000 centimeters into kilometers, it comes to 2 kilometers, which is the same as what I measured out when I used the scale bar.
You can also use scale to estimate the area. For example, I want to estimate the size of Gedge City on this fictional map. Count the number of grid squares that are completely contained within the boundaries of Gedge City. Record this number. I've counted 19 full squares in Gedge City. Then, count how many part squares there are and add them up. This square, for example, occupies an estimated 40% of the square. So I will count this as 0.4 of the square. Now add up the part squares. I've added them up to 9.1. Then add the two totals together. 19 plus 9.1 equals 28.1. Calculate the area in square kilometers of each grid square. This is done by simply multiplying the length by the width of the square. If the area of each square was 1 square kilometer, multiply this figure by the total number of squares. 1 times 28.1 equals 28.1 square kilometers. If each square were 2 square kilometers, you would say 2 times 28.1 equals 56.2 square kilometers.